catch a full of amazing animals.
Yeah, that's right. Our backyards, although can be small in size, can be full of life. Backyards are natural labs. Sometimes they are awesome places to just explore and learn about animals. So, shall we go out and explore our backyard?
Yes.
Have a look, see what we can find.
Safety first. Put gloves to protect your hands and your fingertips.
One thing you can do is lift over bricks, logs or rocks and see what's under them.
Anything under there? Keep checking.
See that one? Oh!
You got something?
Yeah,
skink. Skink? Oh, little one.
Yeah.
Take your gloves off and gently pick him up. We'll try to identify it. Got it?
Yeah.
Let's go and check our books.
And identify it.
So, did you find out what type of a skink it is?
Yeah.
What is it?
Two-toed mulch skink.
A two-toed mulch skink. And how did you identify that?
It has two toes, as you can see. So there's a five-toed mulch skink and a two-toed mulch skink.
All right.
This one has two toes.
There you go. And did you use the field guides for that?
Yep. Yeah.
So field guides like these are extremely useful when you're studying animals and trying to understand and identify what is what. There's a whole bunch of them for reptiles, for other creatures, and very handy to have if you're going out looking for animals and trying to learn about them. Shall we put it back where you found it?
Yep.
Gently take it. If your backyard has a shed, an old shed like this, which we have, or rubble like this, these are awesome places for animals. Do you want to check under some of these?
Yeah.
Can you?
Yeah.
Oh, ooh, ooh, earwig.
Earwig. Earwig. Yeah.
What are those things in the back?
Oh, pincers.
Pincers?
They're for grabbing their prey and for defense. We have not seen these ones though.
That's what these books are so important, so you know what is what and you learn more about their behaviors. Alright, let's put that guy back.
Yeah, I'll put it.
Another one?
Yep.
Can I hold it? Yep.
Thanks.
Is it the same species?
Yeah.
Yes.
Only two toes?
No.
This is a big one.
That's good. Alright, let's leave him. Let's
and did you know skinks' tails can come off without them dying?
Absolutely, that's a good point.
They can just grow them back.
Absolutely. So
and geckos.
Geckos do that too. But what's the importance of that? Why can they do that?
So basically, the skink is running away from the predator and it takes off his tail. And it has little nerves, so it will be wriggling. Then the predator goes for the tail instead, and the skink runs away.
Oh, that's very smart, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, what have you got here?
Millipedes.
It's quite a few, eh?
Yeah.
What about that one? It's resting.
Yeah.
So
if they crawl in like a black ball, they're not dead.
Right. So normally during daytime, they're all resting under these shady, cold places, and at night time. It'll be all coming out, aren't they?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, fire ant.
There's a cricket over there.
Oh, here?
Oh, yeah, there is a cricket there. It's jumping out.
Here?
Yeah.
Do you know what? Those crickets sting.
Another thing that you can do is get a hand rake and tuck under the leaf litter and soil.
Yep. Show them how you do that.
We do it on the side.
Yeah, so what are we looking for? What kind of animals do you normally see raking?
Snakes and stuff.
Oh, yeah. What did you see?
Snakes. Oh, skink. Another one.
Oh, there's skinks around here. Did you get a slater?
Yeah.
Where?
It went here.
There's a rock. Here.
Oh, there's slaters. Get a few slaters onto our tray so we can show them.
One.
Laters are actually crustaceans. Most people will think they're insects.
Yep. They're not insects, they're crustaceans. And what are the other crustaceans, you know?
Crab, lobster.
Lobster, shrimp. So these are actually crustaceans. And if it is an insect, how many pairs of legs would it have?
Six.
How many pairs? Three pairs, six legs. But
like a spider.
As you can see, these guys have way more than six. Right?
They have 10, because all crustaceans have 10 legs.
Take a pot, some crustaceans do. Now, yep, so these are crustaceans, and they're terrestrial crustaceans, meaning they're crustaceans that lives on land.
Garden spiders and daddy long legs.
Oh, see, your garden and around your house will be home to so many different types of spiders. Most of these types of spiders are actually not dangerous, but there are two types in Perth that can do some damage. What are they?
Mouse spider and redback spiders.
And redbacks. Mouse spiders are rare, but redbacks are so common. Let's see whether we can find one.
That's a big one.
Yeah, there you go. There's a house spider here.
Are those eggs? The
white stuff? Yeah, they are actually. And here, you see a few more egg sacs here attached.
I can't see.
And there.
Oh yeah, that's a big one.
So you'll see a lot of these in your backyard. Those are fungi. They're actually puffballs. Anything here?
Yeah.
Check those rocks. Can you lift the massive big one?
This one?
Yeah. Hey boys, look at this. We have something very special here. We have three animals. We have scaly bugs. Those are the scale kind of things on the tree.
Yeah.
And
a ladybug.
A lady beetle and some ants. Now these three have a relationship. The scaly bugs, they feed on the sap of the plant, the juices of the plant, and they make some very sugary secretions. Now the ants love them, and that's what the ants are there for. They look after the scaly bugs, and the scaly bugs give them that secretion. See the ants moving around on the scaly bugs?
Yeah.
So they help each other. But what about the lady beetle?
Oh, they eat the scaly bugs.
Yeah. Lady bugs or lady beetles are predators of scaly bugs and quite a lot of other insects. So these three have a pretty good relationship here on this tree. See, even in a very small space, how much life is there?
Yeah.
Let's see whether we have any more lady beetles around.
But still in a bigger bush.
So there you go. Your own backyard can be an amazing lab for you to go and explore and learn about all these animals. So take some notes, take some photos. And if you have trouble identifying them, feel free to send us some photos. We'll try to help.
See you next time
on Backyard Creatures.
See ya.